Oh my goodness, you're back. You must be a glutton for punishment. Good to see you again. Gunnar Nelson here from Nashville, Tennessee, from my live room yet again with my daily dose of good news. As I always say, if you're a frequent flyer, thank you so much for joining me again. If you're a newbie, make sure you smash that like button, you follow, you join our mailing list, because I want to give you this good news each and every day. And thank you again in advance for just taking 2 minutes out of your day, hopefully for a little bit of an emotional uplift and a takeaway that improves the quality of your life. Now that said, here I'm gonna get right to it, the daily dose of good news. I thought this was absolutely fascinating. As I was doing my research for good news posts, I came upon the news that there are two MIT scientists that have just figured out a way, they've done their proof of concept, and this is working. They have just figured out a way to culture wood and create wood in a lab specifically designed for furniture making and for construction. Now, why is that important? Now, they do still have a long way to go here, but they have figured this whole thing out and they have successfully done this, where I want you to imagine the way we make furniture and the way we harvest our wood and the waste that goes into it, the cost, the expense, and everything. Not only does it impact the environment, but as far as a business is concerned, aside from deforestation and all of that, it's really not that efficient. Because if you think about it, your traditional tree that God makes is a cylindrical pole, okay? In order to make any kind of lumber from that, that would be furniture grade, let alone usable at all, you actually have to take that cylindrical pole and you have to shave it down into board shapes, let's say. Now think about all the sawdust, all the waste, all the scrap that comes off of that. Then you have to pick the best of the best wood for things like furniture and fine furniture and cabinet making and such. They estimate that only about like 1.5 to 3% of all of the wood that they actually harvest from furniture grade trees actually is usable. Now, what incredible waste. Now, not to mention all the slow moving trucks and the fuel and the manpower and all of that that goes into having to go into the hills and harvest the trees. This is a game changer when you think about it. I want you to imagine a future, a near future, where scientists can actually culture, they can grow wood specifically in shapes, already shaped, not cylinders, not like trees, but already shaped in a rectangular shape like board footage, where they can actually make trees and they can make doors and cabinets right from something they grow in a lab. They don't have to harvest trees anymore. They can actually design the grain of this wood specifically in a test tube first before they actually create it. Man, think about it. 5, 10 years from now, imagine if we didn't have to harvest any trees at all to make the best furniture in the world with no waste, relatively speaking. There would be no excuse for anybody in first, second, or third world countries to have to harvest their forest for the making of home goods and furniture and such, because, you know, frankly, we're all motivated by the almighty dollar in business at least, and it just wouldn't be as cost effective. You would make more profit from doing it in a lab. I think that's incredibly exciting when you think about that. What a game changer that is, all right? No more waste, no more deforestation. How incredible, and we are right on the edge of that. Like I said, these two scientists at MIT, they've proven the concept, they've actually done it, they've repeated it in lab conditions, so this is real, and they're working on developing it to a point where it can be practically applied, and I think that's amazing news. So, with all the crazy crap that's going on in the world, there's a little spot of good news that you get to look forward to in the years to come. And on that note, I love you guys. I appreciate you. I want you to go out there and enjoy your lives. Be good to yourselves. Be good to others. And we'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.